Up next from the Soviet Union, the legendary couple Oleg and Ludmila Protopopov. And when we say legendary, it's not hyperbole. They have been innovators in the sport for so many years, winning their first Olympic gold medal in 1964 in Innsbruck. It was the first gold medal ever won by the Soviet Union in figure skating, and they would go on to change the style of pair skating forever. It was also a time when a commentator, we've grown to know, got her start. That lady looked familiar.
Oh, I was so nervous doing that.
He was 32, she was 29. That victory started their domination of the sport, which continued with victories in the World Championships in 1965, 66, here in 1967, and in 1968. Among their innovations was the inside death spiral.
This is a back inside death spiral, a move that
in 1968, Ludmila and Oleg won their second Olympic gold medal in Grenoble with another of their classic balletic performances.
Ludmila hasn't changed very much. Still slender, still in good shape. And you can see their short, quick steps.
What's this?
The overhead lift that they invented.
They retired in 1969, turned professional, and skated with a Soviet troupe based in their hometown of Leningrad. Then in 1974, Ludmila and Oleg journeyed to Tokyo for the first professional skating championship, which they won, and in the capitalistic spirit, they were allowed to keep the money. But upon returning to the Soviet Union, artistic conflicts with authorities led to their defection in 1979. Their first competition in the U.S. was here on Sports World in 1982, which they won, and they've been here every year since.
We are very happy. I would say that we are most happiest pair in the world, because many generations of pair skaters passed, but we're still on the ice, and this is most important.
In yet another experimental program, Ludmila and Oleg will skate to Rhapsody on a Theme of Paganini, in which Oleg plays the great violinist Paganini, who must resist the temptations from the devil, and Ludmila is his violin.
This is the strong part of their skating, interpreting music. They always like to present a different interpretive program to beautiful classical music.
They really are in amazing shape. He's 54, she's 51. And yet they skate with the strength and power of athletes much younger.
Requires unbelievable strength.
Oleg and Ludmila Protopopov, they still live in Switzerland. They train 5 hours a day most of the year, and they take 2 weeks off a year to go down to the warm weather and scuba dive. Let's go over to Jim Cephalo.
Congratulations. The crowd reaction again was wonderful. Is it more important to win this competition for the monetary end and for the pride, or is it to please the audience?
It was a great pleasure to skate our new number, the violin of Paganini. Unfortunately, public here don't know about the name. That is why the reaction so surprising is strange.
Here are your marks. Let's see what the judges had to say.
9.9. 9.8. 9.9. 9.9. 9.9. 9.9. 9.8.
Oleg a little disappointed by the crowd's reaction of 49.4 for the Photo Football. It's a combined score of 98.2, and we'll be back.